Okay, so welcome back to this tutorial. We're going to continue with sets, and we want to look at laws sets. Okay, what are some of the laws that we look at when we are dealing with sets? Okay, so number one, we're talking about laws on sets. So number one, we have what is called the double complement. Okay? Double complement. Okay? So we say that, remember, I talked about equal sets, isn't it? Let's try to remind ourselves of this. I talked about equal sets in the previous lesson. So we said that A and B, A is equal to B if and only if A is a subset of B and B is a subset of what? A. That's what it means, okay? So these are only equal if they are subsets of what? Each other. So now we say that the complement of a complement, A complement in brackets complement, is equal to A. Alright? A complement complement is equal to A. It's as if the two complements are canceling each other. You understand? So let's look at the proof. How do we prove that? Now, this is something very important. You need to know how to prove that. Alright? So, we say that A complement complement is equal to A if and only if, okay, if and only if A complement complement is a subset of what? A, let's say this is one, statement one, and the other way around, A is a subset of what? A complement complement. Okay. So we call with this one statement two. Okay. Now we need to prove that both statement A and statement B are true. Alright, for us to prove that these two are equal to each other, we need to prove that statement A is true, I mean statement 1 is true, and statement 2 is also true. That is, A complement complement, the complement of A complement is equal to set A. And here we also prove that A is what? A subset of what? The complement of A complement. Okay, so now let's prove statement 1. So we can say statement 1. Right? So we say let X be a member of the first set here, which is what? A complement complement. Okay. Now, it's like we have the universal set and then we have the set A. Okay? So we have, let's say, 1 and 2 inside, then let's say 3 and 4 outside. Okay? So what we are saying is that if we look at what is inside, okay, if say A complement, all right, if we say A complement, let's look at this. If we say A, let's try to prove it using the Venn diagram, and then I'm going to explain it further using this method. So if we say A complement, let's look at what is inside first. So this is going to be equal to what? What is A complement? A complement is going to give us what? What is outside set A, but within the universal set, okay? So what is outside set A? We have 3 and 4, okay? Now, remember the universal set is having the elements 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's what is in the universal set. Now, if we say A complement and another complement, it means that what is outside this set, but within the what? The universal set. So what is outside this set? outside set A complement. Okay, what is outside set A complement is 1 and what? 2. Okay, we have 1 and 2. So we've listed A complement. We're saying that A complement is 3 and 4. Now, what is not part of A complement is going to be what? 1 and what? It's going to be 1 and 2. Okay? Now, what is this 1 and 2? What is A? The set A is having the elements 1 and what? 1 and 2. So we can see that the exact elements that are in A complement are the exact elements that are in set A. So from there, from this simple illustration with the Venn diagram, we can see that A complement is equal to what? Set A. Okay. Now, let's get back to our method of proving that. So this implies that if X is a member of A complement, it implies that X is not a member of A complement. Okay? Because if we put complement, it means it's not a member. Just like if we say X is a member of B complement, then this means that X is not a member of B. We remove the complement there, isn't it? So in the same case, we're going to remove the complement and cancel the membership sign there. Alright? So we're going to say that if X is a member of A complement, it means that X is not a member of A complement. Now, what does that mean? It also means that it implies that X is a member of A. Okay? So the complement and the one that is canceling the membership there, it's more like they cancel each other. Okay? So from here we're saying that if X, we're saying that let X be a member of A complement, then it implies that X is not a member of A complement. Okay? It's not part of the set, okay, called A complement. Now, from there, we're saying that it also implies that X is a member of what? A. Because we're saying that it's not part of A complement. Look at this. If we say that A complement, like in this case, A complement is equal to, what is A complement in this case? It's going to be 3 and 4. Okay? Now, if we say elements that are not members of A complement, okay? Members that are not part of A complement, or rather members that are elements that are in A, isn't it? If something is not in A, those that are not in A complement, it means that they are going to be what? Which ones are not part of A complement? They are going to be 2, 1 and 2. Are going to have 1 and 2. Of which, in the end, we're finding that 1 and 2 is the set A. Okay? So, in other words, we're saying that if X is a member of A complement, then it is not a member of A complement. Alright? And then it is a member of the set A. Okay? So, we have seen that whatever is in set A complement is also in set A. So we say that therefore A complement is a subset of what? A. Okay? By this we have proven the first statement, because the first statement that we had was saying that A complement should be a subset of A. Okay? Now let's prove statement 2. Okay? So we say let X be a member of A. Alright? Let X be a member of A. Then conversely. Now the word conversely there means it's like we just go in the reverse. From where we ended here, we go in the reverse. Alright? We go in the reverse. So we are here. We are at this point. So we're going to say that this implies that X is not a member, we come here, is not a member of a complement. We're just going in the reverse. So if you prove the first statement, the second statement is very easy. Okay. So we're saying that if X is a member of A, if X is part of A, then it means that it's not outside A. If I'm inside, then I'm not outside, right? If I'm inside, then I'm not outside, okay? If I'm inside, if this is A, I mean, this is the element X, it's inside A, then it means that it's not outside A. Because complement, we're talking about things that are outside A, okay? So if X is inside A, then it means that it's not in outside A. And if it's not outside A, then obviously it should be inside. It's like you go inside, you find the person that you're looking for, okay? Then you're going to conclude that, oh, this person, since he's inside, then he's not outside. So if you want to prove that you go outside, you got to check, you find that that person is not outside. Okay, so this is where we are. We're saying that X is then a member of what? A complement. Okay, complement. The comp of the outside is the inside. Okay, the opposite of the inside is of the outside is the inside. Okay, so from here we just went in the reverse direction. We said that let X be a member of A, then it implies that X is a member of A complement, which is now a member, it's not a member of A complement, which means that it is a member of A complement. Okay, I'm going to continue it from here. So that means that, therefore, A is a subset of A complement. Okay, now, since both statement 1 and 2 hold, okay, so I have proven that A complement is a subset of A, and A is a subset of A complement. Okay, since both A 1 and 2 hold, then A complement is equal to A. Alright? Since both of those are holding, or rather, since both of them are true, then A complement is equal to A. Alright. So this can be you may be finding confusing a little, but always try to make sure that you go through and try to understand the basics, and then you're going to find that this is going to be quite easy for you to handle. Okay, now let's look at what is called the commutative law. All right, commutative law. So I'm sure in mathematics you've looked at what is called, under algebra, you looked at what is called commutative law in your lower grades, in secondary school or in primary school, and so on. Okay, so let's say number 2, we look at commutative law.